My name is Vinay Bose, and the property is 3450 Benwood Drive, coming 30041.
Is that where you live, sir?
Oh, my residence address is 3001 Wembley Bridge, Atlanta, 30340.
Thank you, sir.
We have a equestrian center which is about 18 acres in size, and it has a barn on it, and it always had a mobile home, and we had a loft on it. This is from day one. This was built in 1995-96. It's been in operation for 22 years, and my position is that it's zoned CBD, but we have always had a residence of some sort on the property. And so I shouldn't even have to apply for this. Given that position, still I was forced to apply, and this is how it went down. We had a trailer on the property which I moved for getting it repaired. And in the process of bringing it back, I encountered a Swanee EMC gentleman who said, why don't you apply for a residential a meter for the mobile home? So I came to the county asking for, they asked me to get a permit. So I came here asking for the permit. And they said, oh, you can't do that because it's not in this zoning, and so you cannot have your trailer there, a mobile home there. And so not only did I not get to take the mobile home back, and I didn't even get a residential permit, so I'm stuck having to apply for this application here. And we have had, like Mr. Brown has also admitted that we have had this mobile home on the property for a long time. So we have had a loft which is about 1,700 square feet plus the mobile home. So we've had many times in a year we have had two or more caretakers taking care of the equestrian center. There are 29 stalls in the barn, and now I'm having to try to get all 2,500 square feet in the barn, so we won't need a trailer, mobile home. So that is the position. That's why I have applied for this. And may I ask if I can reserve my time to answer questions if you have any?
We'll bring you up after public.
Please, because I may need to rebut something that will come up, and it will be useful for your consideration. Thank you.
Is there anybody here who'd like to speak in favor? Please step forward. Anybody who'd like to speak in opposition, please step forward.
Good evening, Commissioner. My name is Jeb Sundgren. I live at 3435 Benwood Drive, coming in the Chattanooga River Club subdivision. I represent, I'm the president of the HOA Board of Directors, and we respectfully request that you reject this application, CP170014, for the following reasons. We believe that a 2,500 square foot caretaker residence is excessive and unnecessary, as illustrated by Mommies Properties LLC's latest submission for dual caretaker's residence in the zoning appeal AP180005. We consider the interior structure of the stables dangerous and unsafe because of unpermitted work performed there in the last year, including pouring concrete foundations, wood supports, and installation of steel I-beams in the ceiling. Additionally, we are extremely concerned with the MRBA and land disturbance violations and their impact on the surrounding wetlands ecosystem balance. They include heavy deforestation, confirmed by comparing aerial images from qpublic.net and Google Maps of the property, and significant land disturbance, including enlarging drain areas with culverts and fill to alter the direction of natural streams and water detention areas, thereby increasing water flow to Hall Creek, which empties into the Chattahoochee River. In closing, we would like nothing more then for the equestrian center to be a well-managed, safe, and accessible amenity available to Chattahoochee River Club and all of Forsyth County residents as outlined in the trail system easement agreement. If construction of a caretaker's residence can be shown to support this objective, the Chattahoochee River Club will not oppose it as long as the residence is of reasonable size, 900 to 1,000 square feet only, and is leased to the stable's caretaker and his or her immediate family for residential purposes only. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Carrie Stone. I live at 3625 Wood Grand Point, also in Chattahoochee River Club neighborhood, coming in for sites. I'm in the second home in that neighborhood, and part of the reason we moved to the neighborhood was because of the trails and amenities that the neighborhood offered, part of which were trails around the swamp in the property that we're discussing. I've had two Girl Scout troops and guest hosted Boy Scouts and multiple neighborhood kids back through the swamp. There's beaver lodges down there. We've witnessed lots of snakes and turtles and migratory birds, and it is a treasure that I love. I have lots of posters of things that we've done and looked at when we were there, badges that we worked on, etc. My concern is that with the work that's been done, there has been a large change to the wetlands area. There's now dirt been pushed into an area that was wetlands. I witnessed lots of trees that have been cut down, shrubs that were there, and where we had a definitive trail that we could walk to and go to the observation deck, and signage that had pictures of the flora and fauna in two different places. One place that's been completely knocked down. There's grass planted there now. There's no sign of any trail. Like I said, the shrubs are gone and grass has been planted to the edge of the water. On another board, there's the pictures and stuff are gone. There's a boardwalk that's there that I can no longer identify where there is a trail that we could access the swamp and still use it for educational purposes. And it's just breaking my heart to see what's going on in the area. And I would like to maintain the treasure that it is.
Anybody else speaking in opposition? I think there was some time left on the opposing side. You could let me back up, please.
Can I reply?
Just put your time back
up.
I'm sorry?
We need to reset the clock.
How much time do I have?
Well, look. She's almost done.
20 seconds.
Rhonda, no pressure. Okay. You go ahead.
Can I go ahead?
Yes, we'll get started. Go ahead, sir.
Oh, okay. The two people you heard from are from Chattahoochee River Club, and this property is not part of Chattahoochee River Club. We have nothing to do with the subdivision per se. So it's on its own standalone. Now, Ms. Sundgren, who's the president of Chattahoochee River Club, must have confused the daylights out of you. This application has nothing to do with anything he's talking about, which is the residential application request inside the barn. And now what has happened is they have used the power, their power and their connections using your office here to make my life miserable for the past 6-7 months. And I have made some appeals on certain decisions that the county has taken, and that has gone up to appeals today. I have a letter here. May I approach or should I give it to the gentleman?
Give the gentleman on the right. He's looking for more exercise.
So
I am requesting in this letter that Commissioner Semanson recuse herself from voting on this issue. And I know the likelihood may not be great on that point, but for the record, I'd like to ask that she recuse herself. Now, the ex-president of Chattahoochee River Club had posted about this. May I continue?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm trying to read your letter you gave me.
Okay. I'll give you a minute.
No, go ahead.
Keep going?
Yes.
Okay. So, they posted in this Chattahoochee River Club, which I learned recently, a few hours back, that they would actually recommend 900 to 1,000 square feet. 900 to 1,000 square feet as a grace for my application. So I have a feeling that's where it's going to go down, but that is not enough for us to run an equestrian facility, which if you all have any experience with equestrian facility, a caretaker residence is sort of goes hand in hand with an equestrian facility or dealing with livestock. So we've had kids and horses themselves who either children come and play and mess around with the horses and let them go because there's nobody there at night. And we have had incidents where these horses go all the way up to 20. And actually one of them got killed not too long ago, a few months back. So I'm going to read this last part for you. May I continue?
Please.
Okay. I'm going to read something that they showed me on a posting, and here's the response from a Chattahoochee homeowner who says, "Can you clarify in response to the Chattahoochee River Club president? Can you clarify why 2,500 square feet isn't a reasonable size?" I'm quoting verbatim. "It's smaller than every home in this neighborhood and approximately half the size of the average square feet in the county. I ask because it could be a family that takes care of business and 900 square feet doesn't seem sufficient. I would like to keep the equestrian center here and wonder why, if it's being built in the loft space without changing the footprint, should be opposite at all. I could not have put it better." And this is coming from one of their own. But people are scared to come up and talk because they don't want to get assessed. I get special assessment and whacked by this homeowners association board. So that's what I heard, and that's why nobody's going to come here and support me from Chattahoochee River Club. And so I'm on my own, and they have support of Commissioner Semanson here. So I'm still, for the record, requesting she recuse herself, and kindly hope the rest of you see the wisdom in letting an equestrian facility be an equestrian facility. Thank you. If you have any questions.
Thank you.
We'll
There's some more time on the other side. If the other side has anything else to say, or anybody wants to speak on the for side before we change over to the opposing side? Does anybody have anything else to say on the opposing side? So, a motion to close the public hearing.
Second.
Please vote. Passes 5-0 is closed. Just, Ken, do you have any comments before we get moving?
Well, I received the letter, and the letter refers to the petition, and the petition is 30 pages plus long, so no, I don't have any response right now. I don't believe it.
Do you feel it's necessary for us to postpone any decisions to give you time to read some of the documents or not?
Give me just a few seconds.
Please. We're going to take a 60-second break while he just glances at that and I grab water for everybody up here.
The petition has really nothing to do with this application, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, the letter says it's requesting that Commissioner Semanson recuse. It says the petition in which Ms. Semanson's acts have been addressed have been served by the county. That's this document, I'm assuming. So I'm looking at the document to find out what the basis is you're asking a commissioner to not vote on action in her district.
Mr. Jarrett, this this has been going on for 7-8 months, and if you recall, I met with you and Commissioner Semanson in the office next door and explained this entire thing. But after our meeting, using the power of the commissioner's office on this very podium, exactly 1 month back, I was able to prove how the county has used, the commissioner's office has used their power to stop all activity on the farm. And this is in this is an appeal of that particular rejection of all appeals. So this has gone to the Superior Court today, and we could today was the last day to file it, and it took some time to put it together, and we filed it today, and county has been served, and ZBA has been served, Mr. Brown has been served this afternoon. But again, that has nothing to do with this application on the table right now.
Mr. Chairman, I don't see anything in the petition that, that demands that the commissioner recuse.
Thank you, sir. I just want to make sure. Thank you. Well, if you all have, I believe we closed the public hearing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. I have a couple questions, if you don't mind. I know that you're Commissioner Smallson, I'm not as familiar with this as you are. Mr. Brown, are you aware of any construction taking place on that property that's not permitted? Is your office or code enforcement aware of being alerted to that?
We've received complaints. We had a meeting scheduled with Mr. Bose to visit the property, and he canceled that meeting.
Maybe we should postpone it so we can get that meeting.
He still doesn't want us on the property.
Very good. And then we also heard about the trails, possible trails that some people are using. Some dirt was moved around. Have we seen anything to that effect? In other words, in wetland areas where dirt shouldn't be moved. And was there permitting for that?
Two examples that are close to that topic. One is there appears to be some type of utility work, trenching utility work on the property. And second, we had issued a stop work after several truckloads of dirt were brought onto the property. We didn't have information as to why the dirt was being brought onto the property, you know, without information being in the urban corridor, and be very cautious and we issued a stop work.
And this property right now is zoned agricultural? Or CBD?
I believe CBD, yes.
I understand why you would be concerned about the dirt. It's not agricultural, but more dirt as it closes. Okay.
May I clarify? He's wrong.
Hang on.
You want to write that?
Hang on. Your time to speak, unless we ask questions, is now over. Public hearing is done.
Okay.
Unless some of the commission may have questions for you. The trail system itself that I'm speaking to, is that on the property for their neighborhood, or is that on your property, which they were trying to use your trail system?
There are trails on both the CRC subdivision and on the property, but the property is private.
Unless they're trying to access theirs. Do you mind, ma'am, would you come up? I would love to hear what the trails that you're trying to access. Do you believe they were on property owned by your HOA neighborhood or by this gentleman, CBD?
No, actually, I moved into the neighborhood in 98. And there was indications of where there were trails in the neighborhood. And part of it was there. And there was signage that matched the rest of the signage that we have on the trails all throughout our property, the neighborhood and the Bowman's Island and et cetera, matched all of that, painted the same lettering, et cetera. And there was a sign that said there was a trail there. Well, that sign's been taken down. And again, the signs that had floor, like what you see at the trout hatchery that explained about the fish and stuff there, there were signs like that. One's been stripped, the other one was knocked down. And there was distinct trails, pathways, and there's a boardwalk back there, and there are two overlook dock-type small path that you could overlook to look at, which done frequently and often, and to see the swamp and the flora and the fauna and the king snakes and muskrats and beaver lodge and everything that we've always come up here to see.
Is Mr. Sundgren still here? Can you give a little bit of clarity on the relationship with respect to easement agreements on the properties?
Our attorney had addressed the trail easement agreement that's in place that allows not only Chattahoochee River Club, but Forsyth County access to the trails that exist on the Stables property. And that's what we were trying to, that's part of what we're trying to gain access back to. Not just the horse trails that exist on the CRC property, but the pedestrian trails, the nature trails that she's speaking about that don't exist anymore. They're overgrown, they're not maintained. We can't have access to it because he's locked the gates to the Stables. We can't access his property. We can't access the trails that exist.
Let me hold you up this for a second. So I'm afraid what his application is asking for is for residents.
Sure.
And I'm just trying to get to where I can see there's a fine line. Sounds like you have possibly a civil matter with him that shouldn't be in the middle of our decision-making process, should it?
That's correct.
I just want to clarify that's what I was hearing. And I want to be sure there's a true separation here.
Correct.
So unfortunately that we cannot discuss with this application. I heard you saying, I just want to ask a few questions, see where we are. I'm sorry to have an issue that, but that sounds like a civil issue. You may want to deal with the council to get what you need back out of that. All right. I just want to make sure about that.
Right, and I just want to make sure that it was established. Just that part of the discussion, you know, that's not the hinge point, that there is a easement agreement. Vinay, I have a couple questions for you.
Yes, ma'am.
When you took the initial trailer off of the property, and you said an employee from Sanji told you to do something differently, and then you found that you couldn't bring the trailer back, did you appeal that decision to actually bring your trailer back onto the property?
Trailer back to the property?
Mm-hmm. Right. You said you took the trailer off the property
right.
To rehab it.
Yeah. You mean the mobile home? Yes.
The mobile home,
yes.
Correct.
Yes.
And when you went to go bring it back, that you were told you could not bring it
correct.
Back, did you... You were told that by an employee of the electric company, by an employee of the county?
Downstairs. Mr. Brown's office.
Did you at any point appeal and establish that you had, tried to establish that you had already had that on the property and it was simply going out for repairs?
Right, that's the entire problem. They said you can't bring it back. So I was not allowed to bring it back, otherwise we won't be doing this. That's why I was saying. We have a property now without a caretaker, and it's impossible to operate.
Was the caretaker actually living in that mobile home until you moved it off the property? And after that point, when did they live on the property somewhere? They lived off the property? Or when you took the mobile home off of the property for that period of time, how did you operate the caretaker?
Great question. Illegally. And illegally, because in the eyes of the county, it's illegal, but that's how it's been operating. The law actually has a full residence, full kitchen, full restroom, full closet, and a living room upstairs.
Right, now, and previously or now after more construction has occurred?
It was built that way. And they also had a mobile home there because just the lock was not enough. And the reason was more than one person was always would be operating, or they have relatives, they have friends. That's how it has been in operation. Taking it out was, I did not realize such a big mistake, because I won't be able to bring it back, and I was not allowed to put anybody back in the loft upstairs. Actually, Mr. Nick, who is gone now, I sat and met with him too, and went over this whole issue. And the only option I was given was to apply for this, which I should not have to apply as my entire life.
Process, why would you not have to apply for it?
Because it has always been there. We have always had people living in the barn on the top. Nobody told you that. They are complaining about 20 other things that has nothing to do with this application. Thank you, sir. And you know, that goes back to my point. Like, you called in to ask about the trails and everything else. It has nothing to do with this. Nothing to do with this application.
Are you currently operating as a stable?
Yes, very poorly.
Is there currently a caretaker on the property?
No. That's why we lost a horse.
Okay. When our staff attempted to come out and to make an inspection of complaints that we had with respect to how the barn was operating, what activities were taking place in it, because as you know very well, there were two conditions that were tied to that original zoning, both of which had to do with restricting the activities only to equestrian activities. Are there other activities occurring with inside that barn?
There never was.
There never was.
It is all equestrian-related activity. And let me go further by saying that Mr. Brown's office is the one that has issued a business license. We've had one for 22 years.
But there's no other type of activity taking place in that barn.
No. How do I go and prove a negative? That's the problem. The CRC homeowners, there are 619 of them. And each one has their own brilliant idea for how I need to live and run my business. And he's using your power to do that. They're using your power to do that.
I understand I've been put into this position to make these decisions within my district, so it's not really appropriate unless I have an interest specifically personally to ask me to recuse.
Sure, but when you go and ask your engineering department or instructors to come and whack me in the property and insist on coming in, what is my first reaction? I said, hold on, let me talk to my attorney. That's exactly why it stopped. And it is not because I did not want anybody to come in. Despite not letting them come in, your guy broke into the property.
Which guy?
What's his name? Pruitt.
What is his name? He broke into the property.
Sure, he did. He stood right here 1 month back and admitted he did. This is the liability. That is what he has on his application there.
Ken, do you agree with that statement?
I agree with that. It's in the application. That's in the petition.
It's on your video camera.
Do you agree with the accusation?
Yeah.
I would have to review the hearing file, but it may be, I just don't know.
Yes, Mr. Brown was here.
So just so you understand how this works, you're not using the power of the commissioner's office to punish somebody. When there are complaints by constituents in the district, they frequently come to the county commissioner's office. Sometimes they go directly to staff. In the case of a more particular piece of property, complaints came from a lot of different places, so there was no inappropriate use of the office. Those are our processes. They did the analysis that they needed to do to determine whether or not they felt it was appropriate to put a stop work order on your facility. I can't put a stop work order on somebody's property.
But you have the power to.
Do I have the power to put a stop work order on anybody's property?
No.
Thank you.
Yes, but you have the power to call the guy who does, which is what happened, right? Because that's what he told us.
Sir, with all due respect, you have that power as well.
No, ma'am.
You have that power to make a phone call to make a complaint.
Ma'am, you knew me. You knew me. You could have called me and asked me. I would have walked you into the property, which is what I told the first inspector, until they started attacking.
I'm not a building inspector. I don't do building inspections. I don't have the skill set. That's why we have staff that does that.
You did not want to allow them onto your property.
Sure, you control their bonuses, their paycheck, therefore you have the power.
Mr. Chairman, let me make a...
We can go round and round.
I was getting ready to, but, yes.
Well, I guess my recommendation is to let's, you know...
I agree.
From the merits of what the applicant does.
Thank you.
So let's get back to, let's stay on the point.
Okay.
If our workers on property, probably don't stay like that too, but I mean, they expect...
I'm sorry, I'm not...
Sir, we'll postpone this for 6 months and then just like this, and then let's speak also, we're not here to argue you back and forth. This is questions and answers, okay?
Yes.
Not arguing tit for tat. If you wish to have your stock work orders released, you're going to have to comply. We don't get in the middle of that. It's up to you. But whether or not we vote on this, allow you to have a conditional use permit to build some residence on it, that's still separate from that.
Mr. Chairman, I have one question. How big was the mobile home that took off?
The entire residence that we were using was about 2,600 or so square feet. Including
home.
The mobile home.
I know, that's one. How big was the mobile home?
Gosh.
Was it double wide or single wide?
Single, long wide.
How long do you think it was, 70 or 80 feet? Or 60?
It could have been much
more. I think it was... I'm sorry, I don't know the exact
size.
I don't want to give you wrong information.
I have a question.
What
would it be, 2,500? Tom, you said the property is on CBD?
Correct.
If it were to stop being stables, I mean, what could go on there?
The property is heavily conditioned. And not word for word, but the conditions basically limited to a pedestrian activity or something very close to that.
Okay, I was worried about that.
In the original zoning, Mr. Brown, was there any conditional use permit for any kind of living quarters, or did we allow those days without having to have a conditional use permit?
And I would have to do more research to answer that.
Because if he's got CBD for all these years and he's kept up his business license, we need to really know that whether or not what he has in there complies. And we need to probably go back in time and do some research to see. And by the way, this range is probably 900 to 1100 was probably the mobile home for this single life, not 2500. But we probably need a little more research. I need some more clear answers before I can make a decision on this.
Tom, if I'm correct, there was a previous application to have those two conditions removed. Is that correct?
Well,
the two that speak to it being maintained as equestrian. That was the first application that came in.
So the one about a year and a half ago?
Yes, Jim Boff was still in the seat.
But you remember that one had a component of the yoga facility that was part of the request. I was just trying to obtain approval to include a yoga facility in the structure, and that application I believe was withdrawn at the end of the day. Either, I can't remember if it was administratively or applicant withdrawn or just withdrawn.
Personally, for me, I'd like to know if he's compliant, non-compliant, and where we stand exactly. Otherwise, we're shooting from the hip, making a decision tonight. His original zoning back in those day and time allowed there to be security on guard on site like they do today, the condition or it might give or not give. I'd like to know if that exists or not.
I can do that research. I'm not going to know. I don't know exactly what's in the structure today, but I can go through in detail what I feel the original approval included and what any subsequent permits require.
Right, and if it didn't have approval and they built it illegally over time, he's saying it was built with the structure as it was built. So see what's in the record, see what's in the plan, see what the mold you've got, and file it downstairs.
Well, counsel.
Right, yes.
Does he have the ability to keep us off his property? I don't like tax appraisers can go on his property.
That is an interesting question, and one that I will confer with the board on offline, if that's all right.
Please.
Mr. Chairman, I will say, and again, I don't, this is going to be dangerous, I'm about to say what I'm saying anyway. I believe the zoning application, and you may know better than me, was 1929. Does that sound
yes,
about right?
Yes, that's right. See it.
So I was able to find it very quickly, and I think it's the right one, and it has two conditions.
Correct.
So just wanted you to know that. I mean, it's not one of these 30 or 40 conditions.
What
that,
year did you say?
I didn't say it here. I just said it's ZA 1929. It's 1995 is the year. And it has two conditions: shall be used for equestrian purposes only, and no retail sales other than those related to the equestrian center will be allowed. Is that about right? I think that's it.
In 1995, did we allow people to live on property on commercial business?
Yeah. Okay. That would require some exploration into our various iterations of our zoning code. I don't know. I just wanted to help you with that piece of it right now.
And tell them if you find that there was, we need to know if there's ever been a lapse in the business license, that the compliant non-compliant would go away, kind of like his mobile home did. Thank you.
Yes.
Commissioner Smith, would you consider a postponement?
I would consider it. I would consider it. Absolutely. Tom, how much time do you need?
Be ready by the next meeting.
I'd like to make a motion that we postpone the chapter decision on old business.
That'll be for the old business July 19th.
We'll move it to old business on July 19th.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. That has been moved to July 19th, the old business calendar.
July.
Number 15, postpone. Number 16, please.
Thank you.
Thank you.